Introductions. We're repeating our introductions, and we've got some other new people who've never been here before. So just do as you're told. I always do as I'm told. Right there. Right there in front of you.
Hi, everyone. How'd I do so far?
The tube is still out.
Oh, okay. All right. Welcome again. Some faces we saw last week, and also a few new folks, brand new and also returning. So welcome, everyone. How many brand new people do we have today? Can I just see a wonderful? Okay. Excellent. Thank you. Okay. My name is Cindy Runkle. I'm the co-founder of the organization, also the accompanist and executive director. So today, I think we're going to probably just get right into singing, but I guess we'll have any other announcements from our chorus manager and chorale pals at break. So with that, this is Brian Leatherman, our conductor, my co-founder, and our artistic director for 5280 Plus. So.
If you were born in the month of January or February, please stand up. This is your punishment. Wednesdays at 11:30, he needs your strength and moral support.
Careful saying that, Miss Cindy. I do.
Oh, that's right.
Okay. Please stand as you're able. We're kind of repeating a few things we said last week for our folks who are brand new to us. We always start with physical and vocal warm-ups to get you. Get the whole body involved. Somebody said, Ben said to me, he runs into people who have sung with us in the past. And he said, why aren't you singing, you know? And he said, oh, I was at the concert. You've got enough people.
What?
Okay, so what you say to those people, you say to those people, we don't exist to give concerts. We exist for your physical and mental health. Get back and sing. Okay, that's why we're here. The concert is a lovely byproduct, but we're here for what we do in rehearsals. And then I'll tell you this, Tom Tollinger, were you at your cardiologist or your pulmonologist? he has difficulties, he needs a cardiologist, a pulmonologist. I think it was the cardiologist, right? And he said, choir came up in the conversation, and the cardiologist said, the single best thing, the single best exercise you can be doing is singing. Good on you.
Yeah, all right. Woo-hoo.
Too bad medical insurance doesn't cover us. Okay.
It's good to have Fran back.
So we're gonna start with this tapping that this is gonna be new. We're gonna do this. Start with a little circle around your intestinal tract and then just expand it. Out one arm. Slap yourself around. Another one. Down one leg. The other one. And poke yourself in the tush. Take your hands like so and give yourself a little neck massage. And face.
Yeah, right.
Now, if you stop and get quiet for a moment, you'll notice that just a really nice little tingle. And it really does help wake you up. It's a really good thing. Would you turn that way? And if your neighbor would like a back rug, please. Rug.
Would you like mohair or shag?
Okay, karate chops down those heavy muscles and say, ah. Face.
A little switch.
Marianne, do you want to announce luncheon? I shan't be able to join you today, but we had the most lovely visit after rehearsal at Olive Garden last week. You new folks, I strongly recommend that you come once in a while. Come with us afterwards, and even if you just come have a glass of water or a cup of coffee. But it's really a great way to meet these wonderful people in this group. Yeah.
He's right. It's really nice to get to meet people. You remember their names. Always wear your name tag in. Today, I'm thinking of going back to a place that's dear to our hearts that we love to go to, and it's Little Holly's down by the intersection of. Do you not want me to go today to Little Holly's?
I can't. I've got a 1:15 meeting.
Did you want to go? You can't go. Would you rather I save it for a day when you guys can go?
Oh, we'll go another time. We'll go another time.
We'll do it again. All right. Little Holly's, it's good, but they don't do individual checks anymore. So whatever you order will be divided among the group that you're sitting with. Usually I think their max group of dividing checks is about 6 people. So when you order, know that whatever you order is going to be divided among everybody at the table. So with credit cards, unless you have cash. So who would like to go to Little Holly's and eat some of their fantastic food? They're really
their
good.
Soup. Their soup.
We have 5. We're not going to have any trouble dividing the check here. Right. 6. Okay. We have 6 people going. If any people decide to go, let me know and I'll add you on. We're always open. If you change your mind, you can always show up. And we're more than happy to have you join.
If you've never been there, their lunch specials are incredible.
Yeah, it's about
$2. You'll take your dinner home with you because you'll have fun, exactly. And their soup is great. All right, wonderful place. Okay, now last week we were talking about this rather private area down here, but when you breathe, this really needs to just relax, okay? Breathing like this does you no good, okay? It's gotta go, and it's just a release, okay? So just do this with me. You're gonna take your hands like this, and we're just gonna go, and let this just go, okay? One guy, Axel Timer, did a clinic that I was attending, anyway, he called it dump truck breathing. So, and you just let everything relax and the air falls deeply into your lungs, okay? The reason this all gets out of the way is your lungs are expanding. Your lungs go to about here, right? And if you get the air in deep, all of this has to get out of the way to allow the air to fall in. The other thing is try not to make any sound. If your throat is a little closed, you'll hear, right? Which is very drying. Not that we don't have dry enough air, right? So really have an open throat and just and let the air fall in. So we're going to do that duck truck breathing, but then I'm going to do something and then I'll ask you to do it back. Okay, and you got to do it in the order. It's the breath in and then I will do some sort of phonation and then I'll point to you and it'll be your turn. So okay, now on the inhale, I shouldn't hear anything. It should be, okay? And when you go, this should work, okay? Now my turn. Ha. I'll do that. That'll help you to breathe. That'll be better than me pointing at you. Okay, my turn. Ho. Is this working? Yes. Do you feel this contracting? Because that's where, it's like you're loading a spring, okay? And that's what then gives you support, breath support, okay? Good. Today, try to think about when you're breathing. I know you're thinking about a lot of things, but try at some point to disconnect yourself from the music and stuff and just connect back into your breathing. And are you letting this release? That's another good reason why we sit up tall, preferably away from the back of the chair, certainly not with crossed legs, because otherwise this can't release and get out of your way. Could we have Jordan number two? And if you look, as I crescendo, as I get louder, crescendo, I'm opening my mouth more to make room for the sound. And we're just going to represent that with bubbles. And you can go any way you want. And you don't have to copy me. We don't want a third grade E. Nice, puckered up. And we're going to just go and up and over. The reason we do the physical gesture is A, to help loosen up your body. And also, if you're doing this, you're not thinking about this. And it's never good to think about this. Here we go. Striving for that release breath. Okay, good. Have a seat and let's look at come rain or come shine. I will repeat what I did last week for those of you who maybe are less familiar with navigating through a choral score. So those of you who are familiar with it, thank you for your indulgence. Come rain or come shine should be the second thing in your folder. Okay, so in most editions, page one is the cover, usually considered cover. And as you see, page two is where the music starts. And that's the reason for that. Now, if you look here, we have these five line staves, and they're in two groups, okay? We call them scores or systems. Top score, top system, bottom score, bottom system. And those are defined by this, you see that tiny little line that's going through all four here over on the left? You all see what I'm talking about? So the keyboard gets the fancy scroll down at the bottom because she's got to have notes for her left hand and her right hand, so she's got two stabs. Most of our music has soprano and alto on the top line of any system, and then tenors and basses on the next line down. And the stem on the note, the little stick sticking out of the little black dot, or sometimes open hole, tells you whether it's for the sopranos with the stem going up, or the altos, the stem's going down. Okay? If the stems are all going the same way, it's assuming you're all singing the same note. Across each of these systems, you'll notice there is occasionally a vertical line. And those vertical lines are called var lines or measure lines. Those are interchangeable terms. And they divide the music into measures or bars, groups of beats. In this particular case, our time signature, 4/4, tells us our beats are going to be grouped in groups of four. Okay? That can change in the middle of a song. Sometimes more often than we wish. You will notice when you go to the tutorials that Chris and I have numbered each measure. It's a lot faster for us to find our way around, okay? So just copy what you see in the tutorial and you'll have the same mistakes we have. That was a joke, laugh. It was so funny. Cherry Creek Chorale concert, I think in October. Margaret, who does our announcements, she said, well, if you're enjoying tonight's concert, consider coming back tomorrow. The music will be the same. The mistakes will be different, but she got a really good laugh out of it. And she didn't know I was in the room listening. She thought I was out in the hall and I just, ha! You know, laughed like that. And then she went, oh, you weren't supposed to hear that. So you'll notice down here in the second system, the second bar in, there's a little box, 5, right? That's an important place in the music because that's where you start singing. There's a piano introduction and then you start singing there. Go over to page 3 and you'll see down at the bottom, all of a sudden for the first time, we have a texture where all four voices are singing. So they put a rehearsal number there, 13. So if they put a rehearsal number, our medley has actual rehearsal letters, A, B, C. But those are just ways for us to find things quickly. This one doesn't have pickups like I was hoping it would, and it don't. So we'll have to deal with that later. But I have a little quiz for you. Would you look at page 7, measure 40. Oh, one other thing I forgot to tell you. In most of our publications, most publishers, either above or below each system over on the left, this one happens to, Alfred tends to put them above, but there's a little measure number, okay? That kind of helps you find things quickly too. But it's easier if I just say measure 43 instead of everything else I might say. But find measure 43 and tell me the first word. Damn, you're good. But it's easier for me to say measure 43 than saying page 7, third system, second bar, okay? And you say, well, big deal. Yes, it is, because over time, those seconds add up. So let us give this a listen.
Flats and sharps.
I'm not gonna deal with flats and sharps right now. We'll deal with those when it becomes imperative. Let's hear now. If you notice at the beginning, it says optional solo. Chris and I haven't decided what we're doing there, so for now we'll just assume it's all the sopranos and altos. So right there at 5, please, Cindy, and then at the top of page 3, then all the tenors and basses will jump in. Here we go. Way at the top, you'll see right below Jay Althaus's name, he's the oranger, you see the word swing. So in this case, our eighth notes are not even. So you don't say, rain or come shine, you say, rain or come shine, yup, ba-dup, ba-dup, ba-dup. The first of each pair of eighth notes will be a little longer, the second will be a little shorter. Let's go on with the tenors and basses at high as a mountain. Ready, go.
Deep as the river, the rain will come shine.
notice that group of three eighth notes? It's got a bar across the top and there's a little three. Sometimes that three has some little wings on it, but that's a triplet. And normally in any beat, and this is a song where the quarter note gets one beat, and if you don't understand that, don't worry about it. But normally a quarter note is divided into two eighth notes. Okay, it's just simple fractions. But here's a place where we've stuck in three notes where two normally go. So whenever you see a little triplet thing, it's just telling you, okay, three of whatever note value it is can be a half note. Most often it's eighth notes or quarter notes. But we're just telling you, okay, we're gonna put three of these notes where normally two would go. So you gotta just move along a little faster. Let us jump down to 13 now. And we'll try it all together for a while and then we'll break it up and go over parts. So we're at 13, here are your pitches. Cindy always rolls pitches from the bottom up. Okay, here we go. Ready, and. Tutorial, you're going to see a dotted line over measure 16 going to measure 17 and NB written under that, and that means no breath. So we're going to want you to go things but and then take your breath on the rest. Okay, doesn't make sense with the punctuation, but it makes sense with the music. Let's go on. Notice we've got both quarter note triplets and eighth notes triplets going on here. Now let's go on right at the word but. Page four, the second measure. And but. Here's a breath. Good enough. This, compared to the songs we were looking at last week, is much more harmonically dense. Okay? Let's take the sopranos and altos at 13, back on page 3. 2, 3, 4. Good job. No tenor, no bass. And sharp, so it becomes necessary here. Let's look at the alto line that in the top staff, sopranos are on top, altos are down below. Look right above the words, don't ever bet me. Okay, so you're singing an F. Now before you look there, look over at the extreme left and look, you'll see the bracket, and then you see a treble clef sign, and then you see a flat sign. It looks like a pointy lowercase b. Y'all with me? It's on the third line. Down in the bass clef, it's on the second line, because that's where B lives in the bass clef staff. But that key signature just is a simple way of saying, okay, we're in the key of either D minor or F major, and we're always going to have a B flat. We're almost always going to have a B flat. So it's just easier to put it over there and not have to write it every time it comes along, right? But because we are doing jazz, we've got, you know, blues rhythms and a lot of complex chords, we're going to have what are called accidentals. And they're called accidentals very properly because usually people have accidents when they get to them. And then foul language ensues and it's just terrible. But anyway, so notice that the altos sing F, 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 and then G flat. Well, G is normally not flatted in this key. So because it is, the arranger wants a G flat there, they have to put in the accidental. Look at the next measure down at the beginning of the next line. Notice there's a G flat again. Well, you told me it was G flat. Why are you telling me again? Because the measure line cancels out all accidentals. The only thing that remains is what's in the key signature. So every time you get to a new measure, if you're gonna have that G flat, you've got to reinstitute it. Now let's look at another spot. Look in the very next measure, and we're gonna again look at the alto line over the words let me. Do you see where I am? Notice there's a C and then a B natural. Well, in the key signature, we have a B flat. So here we want a B natural. B natural is higher than a B flat, okay? I'm trying to look at a place where there's oh, look in measure 19. See the little number 19? Look at the tenor line. Down in the bass clef, it's the top seven notes. Gonna be true. Okay, gonna be, they have B natural. Okay, and then they want a B flat, so they have to write that in. Sometimes you will see accidentals in parentheses, and all that is a reminder of what should be happening, okay? And sometimes just the mere fact that it's there can be a little confusing. When I find a spot like that, I will try to point it out to you. But it's done as a courtesy because maybe, let's say in another part, there was a B flat, or a G flat accidental, but you're gonna sing G natural, they might put in a courtesy natural sign, just to remind you, no, you don't sing that G flat, you're gonna sing a G natural. Let us take the tenors and basses from 13.
And we don't have any trouble being flat.
Here we go, tenors and basses. And up. Tracks on this piece. Let's see, what time should I, what should I be doing? I should be doing, oh boy. That's okay. Let's go on at measure 21. Everybody. 3, 4, 1. Go. By always, and she put a box around it, and she asks us to compare that with measure, that measure 33 with measure 43. So that's the last measure on page 7. Notice that always has a different rhythm. What we just sang is eighth note dotted quarter, so short long. I'm with you always, but at the bottom of page 7 it's I'm with you always. So all is longer than it is in 33. She's pointed out some good stuff there. Let us go on. You're doing really quite well. So I'm just going to scoot on through. And I trust that if there's something that's making you go, what the is that? You'll go listen to your practice tracks. So can we start with the last two notes of 6? 2, 3, 4. Rain or shine. 2, 3, 4. No, they come after the beat. Last two notes of 6. Last two notes of 6. 2, 3, 4. 2, 3, up.
Stop.
that, I believe, she did not mark it and I did not catch it. I think these are soprano, soprano, alto. Oh, they're alto divisis? Thank you. So the middle note will be first altos and the bottom note will be second alto. So two alto parts. Second sopranos, if you want to go sing some first alto, you're welcome. Thank you. Let's just start 39. Days. Scoot on. I would normally take more time in for us, and we will bust that up. But let's keep going. Let's go to, wait a minute. It's 11 o'clock. Oh, I can bust it up a little bit. I gotta stop me when it gets to be 11:05. Let's look where it gets really thick here. Could we take it 39? And can I take the two alto parts? 39, top of page 7. Just the two alto parts. And I heard that little alto part, thank you. Four. Now, so, there are more of you than any other creature on the planet, so that needs to be much stronger. Okay? But I heard the right notes. Just don't be chicken about it. And the nice thing about it, it just kind of, every note's a half step higher than the last one. So that makes it easy. Okay, now let's add the first sopranos, or the sopranos to that. If the soprano line's too high, sing the first alto line, that's fine. As I said last week, whenever you have a three-part texture, we never hear the middle. The middle is never strong enough, because our ear, first thing we hear is the highest pitch. And then we'll hear the lower pitches. Of course, in this case, that means we'll hear the basses. And hope to God they're right. Now, you guys are strong. I'm really impressed with this bass section. 3 and 4. Teach you how to make it rain indoors. So just copy what I'm doing. And then the next thing we do, we'll start slow and we'll get faster. And most of the things that we'll start slow and then we'll speed up. You may need to stand up, but you can do it sitting. I'll let you do it sitting. If you understand, you can. Standing, and then of course if we're up on risers, really great when we're on risers, we won't be on risers, but okay. Now, it works, okay, and then we reverse the process, but we're gonna do this with the audience, and we'll start with on one side of the room and move across the room. Okay. So it's going to be kind of a canon. So as I'm looking at you, do whatever I'm doing and then gradually speed up, okay? But don't start until I'm really looking at you. And then I'll start the next thing, okay? So, not until I'm looking at you. And then you take care of speeding it up. I wasn't looking at you. I wasn't looking at you. I wasn't looking at you. Now you gradually slow down. You start fast and then you slow down. You get it. 300 or 400 or 500 people doing that, and it's really kind of cool. And of course, that's the rains down in Africa. When you look at Africa.
With or without problems.
Let's start right at box 5. There's a chord there at the beginning, so you'll get that. No, that's the piano. Sorry, never mind. So box 5. Da 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 da.
No.
I'm not real worried about where you put the T's. I just don't want them to be exploded. It's not dot, it's dot. So this is da 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 da. It technically it's da 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 da.
No.
If that da is a dot, who cares? I'm happy if you just get the syncopation going. Da 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 da. That's fine with me. So here are your pitches. 1, 2, 3, and 4. Da 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 da. That repeats. Da, 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 da. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3. Stop. Part 1 is the sopranos. Part 2 is the altos. Part 3 is the tenors and basses together. Okay. We're at top page 4. Okay.
You didn't tell him how to repeat.
1, 2. I did. I said it repeats. I shouldn't have to tell you that, Robert. It's printed in the music. But you'll see in the tutorial that I've circled that, and it's a good thing for you to do too. Here we go. We're at 9. We're at 9.
Sorry.
Oh yeah. Yeah. 1. Otherwise, you're going to be very bored. And you will be bored. I promise. Am I thrilled with this arrangement? No. Is there anything else? No. So we're doing it for the sake of the tune. But the audience will love it. 2, 3, 4. I think the drum. Let's slow this down. Let's slow this down. Let's slow this down. I know it's in cut time. I know it's in cut time, but for now let's take it in 4 in tempo di lerno. So it's I heard the drums echoing tonight. do it. Let's take it nice and slow. 1, 2, 3, 4. I heard the drums echo in the room. Oh. Do you think you can take it faster?
Yes.
Okay, we'll take it. We'll take it in a slow cut time. Measure 9. I heard the drums echoing tonight in a slow 2. Slow 2. 2. Ready. And I hear the drums in the morning, but she hears only whispers of some. Has nothing to do with a love story. The guy who wrote the song said it really doesn't have anything to do. It kind of looks like it, as you know. Is this guy torn between this girl who's flying in on this 10:30 flight, or is he going to stay at it? No. He said the song is a reflection of my love of Africa. That's all there is to it. So you can read anything into it you want, but he doesn't agree. Let's start right there at 44. It's gonna take a lot to drag me away from you. 2, 3, and. It's gonna take a lot to drag me away. Farther into the tutorial, when you get into it, you're going to see there's a bunch of stuff I've written in. That's optional stuff if we can add it later once we feel confident, because when you listen to Toto's performance, there are places where they go up an octave and do other things, and it'd be nice if we could do some of that. All I want you to do now is, and it's mostly in the top line or there's eventually a possible solo. Just write it in, but don't worry about it, okay? We haven't gotten there yet. Let's go back and decipher this a little bit more. Can we start at 44 with just the part 3? That's the tenors and basses together. Betty and it's gonna take a lot to take me away. You see there are breath marks. There's always a breath mark before do do, but I will like a breath after your do do. And always breathe after do do. So just so we hit things square. Let's just have the sopranos and altos now. Part 1 and part 2, starting at the top of 9. 3 and 4 and it's gonna take. you know, we are not going to be gonna take some time to do the things we never gonna take some time to do. Very relaxed, colloquial type English. Let's go down to please 62. 62. With repeats. Ready, go. Da 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 da. Oh, sure. Sure. We're just reading through. We're just reading through. If you, if the text is getting in your way, get rid of it. One and two and. The wild dogs cry out in the night as they restless cabin for some solitary company. And one and two and. I know that I must do what's right. All to agree on what the rhythms are. So we'll start with what's written, and then if we don't like something, we really don't like it, we'll change it. Okay? Good. And everybody else, I think your doo-doo was just fine.
It was.
That was really good doo-doo. Let's go on at 84, top of 13. Let's do the part one first. Here's a place where you'll see in the tutorial I've written in some possible octave jumps, but for now we'll just do what's written. Me and I seek to come what's deep inside. One, two, oh, stop. It says, are you all looking at the top of page 14?
Yes.
It says, D.S. Alcoda. They were nice enough to tell you that's on page 9. And the sign is that fancy looking thing up there by box 44. Repeat after me. Why'd they do that? To save paper and ink. Now, let us look ahead, boys and girls. Would you look on the next page, page 10, down at the end, and then go to the second system, and above the first bar, you see two coda, page 14, and then a funny looking like gun sight. Okay, that is only for the second time through. After you go back to the sign, because the message we received at the top of page 14 was DS Alcoda, go dal segno, go to the sign. Alcoda, and then go to the coda. And then when you get to the coda, after you've been to the sign, you go to the coda, which is on page 14 at the bottom with, and just be thankful that most of you have gray hair already, because this kind of stuff can give you gray hair. It's why music teachers develop gray hair earlier than most people, because they have to get their kids to figure this stuff out. Okay, so let us go back to the sign and keep a finger in page 14. And let's just put it all together. Good luck. We're gonna go from page 11, and then when we get to the coda on page, we're gonna start at 44 at the sign on page 9, and when we get to the coda mark on page 10, we're gonna jump over to the coda. So keep your finger in page 14. One and two and out. Up, up. It's gonna take a lot to drag me away from you. There's nothing else. Okay. Did you get to the coda?
Yes.
On page 14.
Yes.
Now notice part one and part two are together on the same staff. Then part three is where they've always been. And then up at the top, there's an ad lib solo where you get to make stuff up. Okay, so forget about the solo right now and just sing part one, two, and three. Let's start right with the word had. Oh, better yet, let's give you another crack at getting from page 10 to page 14. Start at the top of page 10 in the second bar, gonna take, and see if you can get to page 14 on time. Luckily, all you have to sing is a whole note. That gives you about this much time to figure out where the hell we are. We'll see up on stage, we'll see this point. And then somebody will drop their music, too. That'll be good. No, mine will be on a stand. I won't screw it up. Okay, so we are at the top of page 10, second bar. Ready, and gonna take some time. 14. In the first ending. Now look back at measure 93. Tenors and basses. Do you see that small little note there? And the asterisk with do? You only sing that when you go back and repeat. So in other words, when we get to the coda, first of all, when we get to the coda, do not go, had, do rest. I bless? No.
No.
Don't do that.
Rest. I bless the rain.
Here again, I feel they didn't do this to save Aiken money. They did it to be perverse. Blah. We are now at 93 the second time, and you get to say do on the downbeat. Tenors and basses. Ready. 93. Second time. And do I bless the rains of the Africa? Do I bless the rains of the second ending. Two, one, repeat to 104. You'll see in the tutorial, I have decided we're going to do 104 three times.
Oh my gosh.
Page 16.
And Cindy Lou Marie, Esmeralda Ray, Armstrong Wrinkle Jr. 104, 104. Down in measure 106 and 107, where you've got ya da 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 da. You're going to play the left hand only the first and second time. The third time, leave it out.
Say that again.
Do you see where 106 and 107 are? Okay. The left hand. Play that only the first and second time. Leave it out the third time. Okay, 104, first time. First time is mezzo forte, second time is mezzo piano, third time is piano. So quieter each time. One, two, and here you go. Da 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 da. No retard, no retard. And when we get to 108, when we get to 108, pianissimo. When we get to 108, pianissimo.
So cross out the retard there.
Okay, so 108.
Cross out the retard. There will be no retard.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Are we doing from 104 all the way to the end three times?
No.
No.
Okay. Oh, yo, that's right. You don't have the repeat sign, do you?
No.
Point at me and say, that's one.
That's one.
Okay. At the end of the second system, I am so sorry. My handwriting was so good, I mistook it for real printed music. If you believe that, I got some swampland in Florida you'll be really interested in. At the end of the second system,
107?
The end of bar 107, put in a repeat sign. That must have confused the snot out of you. Okay, sorry about that. Let's do that one more time. 104 to 107, three times, and then I'll holler when we're 108, which is at the bottom of the page. Ready? Two, first time. Is that, where's the B flat? That's the tenor bass. Ready, go. Da 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 da. We're doing 104 three times. We're doing 104 three times. And then we go to 108.
Got it.
Okay.
Well, I know that's what you did, but I didn't understand. I didn't get
that. That's okay. Times. It's all written in the tutorial. I think you'll get it. A few people, I've had three people get a hold of me, and on their cell phone, they have not been able to get to the current practice tracks. Okay, good, I'm glad I said something. Then you need to completely shut your phone off. Not just darken it, shut it off. Completely power it down, and then once you can turn it back on, it should work. It's worked for the three people that had a problem. Ask me why. I have no idea. Hey, we've never had that issue before, but in all three cases when somebody has contacted me about that, I said try turning it off and turning it back on, and I mean totally powering it down.
They're doing this.
And then turn it back on, and then, and in all three cases it worked.
To repeat.
But be careful and don't touch
the
emergency.
Nope. Nobody's had any trouble. Well, one person had trouble with their computer, but they were just looking in the wrong place. Yep.
Four times. That's what he said.
Somebody in South Suburban said there's a way to get your cart off of Bose into where you can just listen to your cart and not have to scroll through.
Then talk to them, because I
don't know
how
to do it.
I have no idea how to do that.
Does anybody know who that is?
We're not South Suburban.
I know, but there's a lot of crossover.
Okay. Personally, I think they're full of it, but I know of no way to do that. I don't know any way to do that. No way to do that.
They did it somehow.
Magic. I have no idea how they did it. And I don't care. Yes.
Is that a three-time repeat or a
three.
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 We only sing it three times.
Three. 104 to 107, three times. It's in the tutorial. Go to the tutorial. Write down what's written on the tutorial. There was a question over here. I have no idea what was going on. So turn it off, turn it on. If it still doesn't work, buy a new phone. Oh, and then remember, when you go to the website, refresh all the time, because the little box that we put up there at the beginning with current information won't change. Also, you wouldn't get weather issues unless you refresh your web page. But if you make a habit of always closing the tab, then it'll refresh automatically. I don't have anything else. What do you have? I'm not going to go through the whole. Oh, yes. Please, no scented products of any kind. That includes your dryer sheets, your fabric softeners. Don't use Irish Spring soap. you do, rinse it off really well. Don't carry mothballs in your pocket.
And you can write on these.
Patricia, sorry about that. No, we have people who have very strong allergies. The main thing is, you know, your scented hairsprays. Usually your soap and stuff like that wears off. But scented shampoos. When women come up and hug me and kiss me and love on me, I smell it, you know. It's nice, but you're causing some people trouble. The guys don't tend to come up and hug and kiss and smooch me, so.
You don't shower.
Then I'm doubly thankful. Afterwards today, you new folks, we need you to stick around briefly. And if you want to stick around, you can all stick around, but the Corral Pals will take you through some very important information. And if you've got questions, they're great people to ask. So please stick around afterwards. What do you think, Kathy, about 20 minutes? Kathy, think about 20 minutes?
We're gonna ask that all the new people come over to this area so that we can get started sooner when people are.
You can come over to the land of the blessed if you're new. Yeah. And you may sit in an alto chair briefly.
Wow. This is really wonderful.
But don't get in a habit of it, because we reserve that for the blessed. Because you notice they're on my right hand. And of course you notice who's on the left hand.
Is that why I'm on the right?
Of course. Any questions about anything? Yeah.
Quick question. What is the corral that you were referring to? Are you talking about rainy days? The corral that you just referred to. Is just a group?
No, Corral Pals.
Corral Pals.
Corral Pals. The Corral Pals for the new folks or any old folks who would like a refresher on it.
Thank you.
Registration is closed tonight.
Oh, registration's closed tonight. Okay? So and close of business. So if you're gonna journus. Okay. But remember, you're always welcome to invite people to come to rehearsal. We always have spare packets of music each week, don't we? So love to have them. It's a great way to infect them with your particular brand of joy. Can you think of anything? Okay, would you look at your watch? Would you add 10 minutes to that and be back and ready to sing? Singing in the Rain. We need to finish what we didn't do last week. Boy, I was clear as mud on Africa, wasn't I? She had asked for clarification, and I wasn't sure what she did. So anyway, she had called me and said, what does this mean? I said, I don't have my score. You'd have to be looking at the music. Well, let's be sure we talk about it on Monday.
Hey, Jimmy, great to see you, guys. I missed you last time.
Yeah, but she didn't understand. There was something she couldn't read on the tutorial. Something wasn't clear, so I just went through everything where I read something and said, I don't know what you can't read. This is what it means. And I proved it.
Sometimes out there.
Sometimes out there.
We'll talk about it.
See, I can't believe some of the excuses I've heard. You know, just I can't believe some of the excuses.
Activity for the
that I heard of.
Hey, where's your name tag?
On my bedpost where I wouldn't forget it.
Anyway, I'm Bob, by the way.
I'm Mary.
How are you?
Nice to meet you.
Thank you.
And I just make a little bit. I saw the 16.
I told my doctor,
she was like,
granddaughter plays.
I meant to be in the two of the high school.
Oh, you do? She's at the middle school. She's just starting in Highland Ranch. Highland Ranch has a high school and the middle school. Oh, really? Where do you live? I think you're right down.
Just across.
Next Friday, the 23rd, you have rehearsal here.
We always have it.
Finish up Singing in the Rain. Let's get to the stuff we didn't get to last week. Sydney and I were just talking. You guys are good readers, and it's also obvious you've been spending some time with your practice tracks. So thank you. And you know, some people say, well, I better practice, so you know, the reason you do it is for you. You don't do it for me or for Cindy or for anybody else. You do it for you. Because there's nothing quite so good as a rehearsal when you feel confident in the music. It just feels good. So I want you to feel good. I feel good. Like I knew that. Let's start at measure 76 in Singing in the Rain. We didn't get to that last week, because somebody blathered on a bit too much. So we're starting with the last two notes of page 9. Let the storm, a 1, 2, go. Let the storm. Starting with the last two notes of 9.
1, 2, 3.
Chase. There's a staccato mark. It's short. One, two, three. Let the thank you. This one's long. Off breath. Little teacher moment. Look at measure 83. That's the bottom score, first measure. Notice there's a G natural there. That's a courtesy accidental. Because if you look at the time, the key signature has one sharp, F sharp. So they didn't have to put that there, but the reason they did it is in the previous measure, the alto sang a G sharp. And they're just reminding you that's the accidental when you get there. So they didn't have to do that, but they did. That was a nice thing, especially since you're changing lines and everything else. Good. Now, can we start at the top of 11? And this is soprano, soprano, alto, divisi. So can I just have the sopranos with the pickup? And we talked about that last week for you new folks. Anytime we start on a note that's not on the downbeat or the first beat of a bar, but we're starting a little before the bar, that's just always called a pickup. It might be one note like this. We had a two note pickup to page 10, right? Let the story, sometimes a pickup is most of a measure. It's just a weird thing. But anyway, we'll start with the pickup, 289, with just the two soprano parts. No alto, no tenor, no bass, please. One, two, go. If you look at the tutorial, in the lower four parts, second soprano, alto, tenor, and bass, I've written in a lot of breath marks. So it'll be just singing, just singing, just singing, just singing. I want you to take the breath so we hear the rearticulation. Okay? I don't want to go just singing, just singing, just singing, just singing. It's much better if we hear the rearticulation. So make sure when you look at the tutorial, you get those extra breath marks written in. You can't miss them, they're in red. Okay? Now let's add the altos to that. So top three parts. When I say breath, I'm talking to the second sopranos and the altos. I'm not talking to the first sopranos. They get that, just fly away, honey. One, two, three. Just breath. Top of 11, pickups to 89. The last note of it, top of 11. One, two, go. Breath. 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 Now, to be careful, because it's been eighth note, singing, and this one is singing. Got to stretch it. You might put a vertical line or a horizontal line over the note just to remind you, or under the word just to remind you it's longer. Go on from there. Let's take the last measure of 11 and turn the page. Tenors and bass. In the. Ready, go. In the. Now let's do our doodles. Just please. soprano only. One, starting at 97. One, two, ready, go. Right. If you can, doody doodle. Why? I don't know. Do you think Donald and Debbie doody actually, doodle. And Gene sang doody?
No. A
doody
doodle.
Doody, when I say it's cool, I gotta go.
Try to get your duty in there. One, two, soprano, go. Doody, 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 doody. those, the last time you sing do 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 do, notice above it says even eighths.
Even eighths.
Now let's have the altos join that. 1, 2, 97 do. Tenor and bass. I think you can do it together. 2, 3, 4. Said, forget it, guys. You're good. Just... And ladies. And then at the very end, female tenors sing the B. Male tenors sing the A. So here's the B. I'm down in the next to last bar, right? Here's the female tenor singing the B. And male tenor singing an A. And then all the basses down on G. This is the reverse of what happens at the beginning, because at the beginning we start with the sopranos, then we add the altos, then we add the tenors and basses. So we just reverse the process. Let's look at Here's That Rainy Day, the part we didn't get to last time. Start on measure 36.
Page 6.
There are all kinds of tricky little rests in this and places where we have changed the rhythm. So be sure you get those, transfer those markings from the tutorial. And for those of you who weren't here last week, we're changing tutorials from videos, which can be rather time consuming, to just scans of our scores. So you can go through and mark your score in probably less than 5 minutes. I hope you're finding it to be beneficial and efficacious. 36. Bass and tenor. And one. Stretch. Tenor and bass together, my lover near. And go.
My lover near.
Around the, your last note basses, write a triangle that goes like that.
Okay.
Triangle that points up. I don't see no pencils moving.
Well, the E naturals are proper.
Let's go to the top of the next page. And let's continue with the basses and the tenors. 3 and 4. It's just 2 eighth notes and a rest. So you don't get to hang on to funny.
Right.
To go.
So funny.
Get off, get off, get off. Do it again.
So funny.
No. Somebody's going, so funny. It's not funny anymore. It's just 2 eighth notes. So funny. You will do it correctly or there will be repercussions. Go.
So funny.
I know who you are. I will send the SS to your home, and they will make you practice. That Rainy, go on with that Rainy. 2, 3.
That Rainy Day is here.
2, 3, 4, 1, 2. Rest
is here.
Tempo just changes all over the place here. Let's take the sopranos and altos at 44. 3 and 4, 5. Love. It was over here at the alto section. How funny.
So funny.
You scared him.
Oh,
so
frightening.
So
funny.
Ooh. That was really good. All of you. Or I should say besser.
Besser.
Okay. Did we finish this? Everybody, pick up to 48. And.
So funny.
Those rainy days, the big medley. Rainy, the rain song. Do the one with rain in it. Makes me need to go to the bathroom talking about rain all the time. Here we go. Right from the tippy top. Let's just see what happens. Play the accompaniment. We'll see how many scraped noses we get. You have a harmony part there. So instead of so I just, it's so I just did. So you make sure you know that you're singing harmony there. Pick up to B. 1, 2, 3.
So I just did be some talking to the sun.
Thank you.
And I
sopranos and altos, pick up to C. Pick up to C, soprano and alto. 3, 4, 1. Notice altos in top of page three in the third bar. Notice that eighth rest that's wedged in there? You're gonna take a breath before defeat me. The sopranos are gonna carry over. So make sure you're doing that. Tenors and basses in that same spot. You've got a breath, okay? So you've gotta take a breath. Let's have the tenors and basses pick up to C. One, two, go. Again, three, four, one. Basses. You don't come in until beat four. One, two, go.
But there's one thing I
know. Off. Okay, sopranos, you're on your own. She's not going to play your part. Altos, lay out. Play tenor and bass. Pickups to C. One, two, go. Off. 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 Good. Altos, join us. Pick up the C. Altos, join us. One, two, three, four, one. Basses, very important. There, one thing I know. No, you move on beat two. It's not syncopated. You're the most important thing in the room right there. Except, of course, because she also moves on beat two. One, pick up C. One, two, oh, they're coming for you. See, you didn't cut off funny shirts, and they're coming. Look real mean. Look at them and look real mean. Three, four, one. Singing one of those, you're fine. Let's start to learn Over the Rainbow. Yes, it is getting chilly in here. I don't think we have any control over it.
Didn't pay the heat bill.
Okay, Over the Rainbow. Anybody ever heard this song before?
No.
Okay, I'm just gonna throw you in the deep end of the pool. Cindy's gonna play the accompaniment. Good luck!
Are you starting?
Right at the beginning.
Thank you.
si molto retarde stupido in 22. Just keeps going, my God. By the way, do any of you ever remember her singing this in the movie?
No.
Never. We're singing it anyway, but I just wanted to make sure it wasn't just me. And how many of you were afraid of the monkeys?
Tornado.
22. To a place behind the sun in temple. And one.
To a place behind the sun.
Above the stairs, and if you were looking up here with half an eyeball, you would have seen us subdividing.
If happy little birds fly beyond the rainbow.
Breath. Because I have got a lot of directions for you, but let's go back to the first place you will see stuff scribbled in the score on page 7. Starting at the second bar, well, in the first bar, the divisi is soprano, alto, alto. And I believe that's the way the recordings are. Aren't they done that way? I would like, I don't know why I would have written it any other way, but I would like some of the second sopranos to sing the notes that I've circled in the score. So go in there and find it. I'd like you to go down and help in the middle. And I've done that in every place where I want that. And then you can go, and then it says, then all second sopranos go back to soprano. So look in the tutorial for the places where I've circled notes and ask second sopranos to go down to sing the middle note. This is a spot. Can I have page 6, the last measure, tenor and bass.
Yes, and there's.
Oh, yes, there's.
Right.
Yeah.
It's S1, S2.
It's soprano 1 and 2.
On
the recording. Well, good. Then it's already handled. Why in the world did I do that? Anyway, good. Then it's handled. But some of the first altos could go up and sing the middle note. Could I have the tenor and bass, bottom 6, last bar? And then when it splits here, now I wrote tenor, bass, bass. I don't think it's, isn't that the way it is with 2 bass parts and 1 tenor part? That's what I think it is, yeah. Sorry about that. Here we go, last bar, tenor, bass. And 1.
Oh, yes,
starting in the last bar of 6. What?
2 bass parts.
It's bass baritone.
Yeah,
tenor
bass bass.
Yeah, okay. Good. Well, that's even a blind dog gets a bone once in a while. Sopranos now to the last bar of 6. 3, 4. Would you play play alto, and then when they're, no, you say these are soprano divisi.
Yes.
Okay, so would you play soprano, and when there are 3 notes, play the top 2, so that we hear that middle note. No alto at all. Sometimes you can, like, well, okay, if the seconds sing it, great. If they don't, great. But those are really important. Can we try all of you there? Remember, don't come in when the tenors, when the sopranos do, and the altos, you gotta wait a half a beat. And then. Skip over to a similar spot. On page 9, I have sopranos dividing. So that's the way the recordings are. Could we go bottom of 8, last note, soprano and alto? 2 and 3 and 4. To hear their parts if you're singing alone. Now, can I hear just soprano? Start at Troubles Melt. It's kind of a nice part. It's kind of a nice part. And I was hearing it. Good. Now, back up to page 8, top of page 8, here's another place where in the tutorial you'll see some circled notes. So I screwed up and said some second sopranos on circled notes. I said alto 1 and some second sopranos, but it's really soprano 2 and some alto 1s. But anyway, just help me out with the middle notes. It's like it that earlier one we did. Could we look at the tenor and bass on the bottom of page 8? Let's start up in the middle score. I'd wake up where the clouds are far, but then when we get to hind, that's tenor bass. I'm pretty sure that's the way it's recorded. Anyway, I would like the female tenors up on the high F, the male tenors on the C, and all the basses on the G. So could we start at wake up where the clouds? Tenor bass only. And
wake up where the clouds are.
Where's the C? that's the male tenors. Again, and I'll sing the male tenor part. 44. Ready, and.
Wake up where the smiles are far behind me.
That's the male tenor part.
Wake up where the clouds are far behind me.
That's your part there, okay? Cool. Well, there's another little sticky spot. Page 10, there's another place where I've circled some notes in the middle there. So altos, help us out there. And I'm sorry that my directions are weird.
You know, it's because we did it differently.
No, it's not. Well, I thought I had listened to the recording. I thought I watched the recording. Although this is new. This is my new score and the way I wrote them this time.
I haven't worked the old way, so.
Anyway. Okay. And when we get down, let's take, that's the same thing. I want to make sure the baritones are hearing their part. Can we start on page 10, top, last note, last measure, where birds fly, and just do, the bass or the bottom two parts, if there are three, okay?
Birds fly. Why then, oh
my God. Who's going to sing when there are two bass parts? Who's going to sing the upper? Good. And who's going to sing the lower? And who's going to sing the other part? That's the one you make up because you don't know what your part is. That's tenor bass bass. One more time, same thing. Just bass. Or bass baritone.
Birds fly over the rainbow. Why then, oh, why can't I?
Everybody, top of the page, last bar. 3, 4. Ladies, those are super important.
Could I just hear the bass part?
Mm-hmm.
Thank you.
Cool. Let's look at You've Got a Friend in Me and see what the notes really are.
Why do you
want to
change things?
What's that old thing? Hope never dies.
That's a different song.
Hope never dies. Speaking of hope, Cherry Creek Corral has a concert coming up on March 8th and 9th. It's called Hope's Journey. And it's got some of them. They're really loving this stuff. And it starts in a slightly dark place, not real dark. We could have started with the first chorus from the Bach St. John Passion, but we start with the last chorus, which is just gorgeous. And so we start in a place where we might be a little sad, but then we gradually come out into the sunshine and we end with like, ain't that good news, great day, a combination of you'll never walk alone and climb every mountain.
Wow.
It's pretty nice. A couple of Elaine Hagenberg pieces. The guys are doing the Prisoner's Chorus from Beethoven's Fidelio. The guys, the tenors and basses. There's some girls in there too. So it's a really nice program. And early on they said, boy, I really like this music. So I will have discounted tickets for you starting next week. There's a question, I saw a hand flying. Okay, so let us just take parts, please. At box 8. Just play parts. 2, 3, 4. Get off. One. Stop. Tenor and bass. Top of three. Second bar. On the road books. Tenor and bass. No alto, no soprano, please. Three, four, one. Sopranos and altos, same place. Top of three, second bar. Three, four, one. Everybody, top of three, second bar. Three, four, one. Good, go on. To the choreography that I don't think is in any of the tutorials about it is, you just remember what your old pal said, son. So, give me the finger on son. We do it because we don't tend to hear it, okay? So to help you remember, you've gotta go, said son. So can we sing that through and really, really make sure I hear the word son. Do one. You just remember. So start dropping off right away. And that's when Chris and I are gonna go. It's not illness. It's not failing health. Okay, let's go on at 30. Is there anything in there you wanna hear? Do spend a little time with your practice track and refresh your memories to what ideally you would be singing. Once the fur starts to fly. 24, 24, one. Two, ready, go. Yeah, we're making stuff up, basses. Just listen. 24, don't sing. Tenors, don't sing.
Don't sing.
Don't sing. 24.
Ooh, you've got a friend.
Listen carefully.
If you've got troubles, then I got them too.
Or if you've
got troubles, then I got them too.
Okay? The stuff you're making up isn't nearly as good as what's written. 24, everybody. 24, everybody. 3, 4. Make less of a deal out of get the stick. Okay? Just toss those 16th notes up. But when you get see it through, cause you've. Can you make a bigger deal out of that syncopation? And the way you do that is you shorten all of the notes. 32. Really, really quick 16ths. Ready and go.
If we sit together, we can see it through. Go on.
And one. Sopranos in English, please. 38, 3, 4. I couldn't hear you.
What?
You were hiding. You will make it big and strong like Lady Cow. 338, three. Now, that doesn't mean you have to sing blastissimo underneath them. You only got a whole note and the word aw. Okay, ain't that important. If you can't hear the sopranos, get out of their way.
Okay.
And you, give them a way to get out of. I think that makes sense. 38, one, two, three, four. Scale of 1 to 10, you were a 10. You were an 8 because you were too loud. And you were a 6 because you weren't loud enough yet. But it's better than the 2.5 you were giving me the first 2 times. Okay? Now you knock it up to a 10, which means you're going to sing quieter. You do just what you did.
Thank you.
And you sing! 3, 4, 1. When you get to maybe, like, where the hell is that really? Do you ever kind of feel like, So let's do that a few times. Can we start at page 6, right at the edge? Little bit smarter than I am. That was great, sopranos. 3. And we're really gunning for maybe, which is off the beat and syncopated and weird. 3, 4. Little bit stronger than I am. Okay, now, when I do this, that's your breath. It's not your attack. Because I'm on the beat, and you're not.
Okay.
Same thing. Good, Spanish. 3, 4. Little bit smarter than I am. Good. Now, can B be short?
Maybe.
Not maybe, but maybe. It's getting gooder and gooder. Thank you. Ready, go. Little bit stronger than I am. Bigger than stronger too. Good, 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 good. Now, that's really, maybe is perfect, but can you attack but? Because that's important. Maybe, but, you know, it was always, that's what you did to your kids. But,
but.
You ever do that again? Okay, one more time. Give me a big butt. Now you should have said, you've already got one. Here we go, little bit, go. Little bit stronger than I am. Watch out for the snow. Get home. Be safe. Thank you. Thank you, Cindy.